We started in 2002, that was the idea. There was a girl missing in Germany and everybody was searching for her. In 2002 we didn't have the mobile phones like we have now, and it was in the papers, it was on the news, and somebody was missing. And we see it every 2 or 3 years that somebody is missing and you find them back, mostly raped and murdered. At that time I had the idea for, is it possible to make an emergency button on every mobile phone? The mobile phone was that big in that time, and GPS was just coming up for commercial use. But we had the idea to make a mobile phone with a button on it. It started with making our own phones without a display, only wear a pocket or a little box on your belt to push a button on. But now it's that far that we can use all mobile phones, the iPhone and the Android phones, to make an emergency alarm. We do that already for the business. We've got a lot of people working now on the street going to their clients, for example in the mental care, and they want to have the same protection when they had it at home. And when they normally work in their own environment, they get their own button, they can push the button and 10 or 20 colleagues will help them in their problems. We've made the same system now working on your mobile phone. By pushing one button, you can make an alarm call. Voice is straight going to the monitoring center. They can listen in. They've got your position, even when you are indoor, because that's very important. But GPS, it's very nice when you travel around and you want to have your holiday position. But when you want to have an emergency call, you need also the indoor position. So we are using also IPS, where the I is standing for indoor positioning, to give the right correction and the right position to the people who are in danger and need help. For that part, we have now made an app, and in the meantime, we see that a lot of apps are already used, or a lot of communications already used by governments. We see in the Netherlands, for example, NL Alert. It's very good. We have, because the people on DIFD are going to tell how it works and what they can do with it. But you can also see where Amber Alert. There's also a message system. We see all kind of systems where people want to communicate with the police, making an alarm, for example, 112, call them. But normally the position is not correct. So I think it's better to use one app where everybody can be informed from out of the government when there is a disaster. That is anonymous. You don't be recognized in the system, but you only get the warning. But there should also be a way that you can warn the government, or that you can warn the people around you. The same we already do in the business, because we don't want to bother a lot of people when you have a problem. We only want to inform the people who are next to you. And the next person could be a neighbor, could be a colleague, could be somebody in the neighborhood who's helping you, but it could also be a professional guard. And we've got a lot of professional guards working for us now in the Netherlands. They've got all the app on their phone, so when there is an emergency outside in the field and you push the button, we notice where those guys are and they can help you. And you can see it as an Uber app. You've got a cab driver, he's got an app on his phone because he wants to have a drive, and you've got people who wants to order an app. Yeah, both are communicating through those apps, and by pushing a button on the Uber app, you can call a cab. By pushing a button on our app, you can call a security guard. Is that so far? The movie's telling you everything. When you've got questions, I'm on the table.
Breakfast, a short impulse, so that the others can speak, and we have time for question and remarks before 9:30. So. Okay.